Welcome to the course of Unix and Shell Programming. This course is for 3rd BTech first sem. Myself G. Prashanthi, Vignesh Lara Institute of Technology and Science, Department of Information Technology. So in today's class we are going to study about the absolute form in chmod. Okay, already in previous class we have seen the command chmod, where this command is used for changing the permissions. Okay, so chmod in the sense change mode. Okay, where this is for changing the permissions of a particular file. Okay, for a particular file or for a particular directory, we can change the permissions by using this command. Where in the previous class, we have seen the symbolic mode, where the symbolic mode takes the attributes. Attributes like read, write, execute. Okay, for giving the read permission, write permission, execute permission, and similarly for users. So if it is users, you will be saying you. If it is group, you have to say G. And if it is others, you have to say O. Okay. And similarly, the operations, like if you want to add execute permission or read permission, you will be saying plus. Okay. If you want to remove any permission, you will be saying minus. Okay. If you want to give exact access, you will be giving the equal to symbol. Okay. So for adding any permission, for removing the permission, if you want to give an exact permissions, then you have to use the equal to symbol. So for example, suppose I want to give some, okay, I want to give some permission to group and others. Okay, so for group and others, I want to add the read permission. So then I have to say, since it is like adding, I am going to say plus. Okay, so plus. And then read permission, I want to give read permission, so R, and then the file name, like file 1. Okay, so in that way we will be giving the permission, okay, whoever we want. If we want to give for others, okay, so here we will be saying chmod. So if I want to give like others execute permission, okay, so I am saying O E plus execute file 1. Okay, so here by using these access specifiers like permissions for R, W, X and users U, G, O and for operations like plus, minus, equal to, by using these attributes we will be changing the permissions for a particular file. Okay, so this method is said to be the, this form is said to be the symbolic form. Okay, so and similar to this, we are having another form called as the absolute form. Okay, so this absolute form is also used for changing the permissions of a particular file. Okay, so here this is the other way. This is the other way to use the chmod command. Okay, in which you specify a set of 3 numbers. Okay, here we are going, instead of saying R, W, X in symbolic mode, so where in symbolic mode for giving read permission we are saying R, for write permission W and for execute permission X. In this absolute mode, so if you want to say the read permission, you have to use the number 4. Okay, if you want to give the write permission, you have to use the number 2, and if it is execute permission, you have to use the number 1. Okay, so which specify a set of 3 numbers. So these are the 3 numbers, 4, 2, 1. Okay, so that together determine, that together determine all the access classes and types. Okay, together determine all the, together means that if I want to give read write, okay, if I want to give read write, then what I have to say is that since read is 4 and write is 2, so what I have to say, 4 plus 2, that is 6. Okay, so this means that if you want to give read write permission, then you have to say 6. Okay, so that together determines all the access classes and the types. Okay, rather than being able to change only particular attributes, you can specify the entire state of the file permissions. Okay, so here the 3 numbers are specified in order. So whatever the 3 numbers you are using, okay, those numbers will be specified in the order, and user, group and others. Okay, so like here you will be specifying in 3 numbers. Okay, so one is for user and other is for group, and the third one is for the others. Okay, okay? Each number is the sum of the values that specify. Here we have to sum. So here each number is the sum of the values that specify read, write and execute access. Okay, so here whatever the numbers you are giving, so whatever the you have to give one number for user, we have to give one number for group, and we have to give another number for the others. Okay, so and each number is the sum. So here, like this is the sum, read, write, 6. Okay, so and each number is the sum of the values that specify read, write, and execute access. Okay. So, this is like permissions that we are having, okay. So, if it is a read permission, then we will be using 4. If it is a write permission, we will be saying 2. And if it is execute, then we will be saying 1, okay. And here 3 numbers. So, here, so this is one number is for, okay. These 3 numbers, one number, okay. One number is for the users. Okay, so other number, the second number is for the group and the third number is for the others. Okay, so that is what here they have said that. So here the 3 numbers specified in order. Here you have to specify in order. User, group and others. You should not exchange that order. Okay, you can't exchange the order like group, other, user. Okay, you can't exchange like that. So here user is given first order, group, second, next group and then other. Okay, and here each number, so what he is saying here, each number is the sum of the values that specify read, write and execute permission. Okay, so here we can see, if suppose this is the sum, this is the 7. Okay, so here this is like 7. So how you are getting 7? 7 is the sum of the number, read, write and execute permissions. Okay, it is the sum. Each number is the sum of the values. Okay, each number is the sum of the values that specify read, write and execute access. Okay, so here each number, this 7, if you take like 7, okay, so if you take like this 7, okay, so if this is the 7, so this 7 is the sum of these 3 values. Okay, 4 plus 2 plus 1. Okay, that is read permission, write permission, execute permission. That means that here whoever the users we are having, those users are given with read, write, execute permission. Okay, and similarly this second 5. So 5 is for group. Okay, so here 5 means total 4 plus 1. Okay, where 4 is for read and 1 is for execute. Okay, where here for write, it is 0. Okay, if it is write, it means that 0. 4 plus 0 plus 1, that is 5. Okay, so that is, that means that this group, whoever the group that you are having, those are given with the read and execute permissions. Okay, so the group is 5. 5 means that they are given with the read and execute permission. Similarly for others, others is given with 5. Okay, so 5 means again sum is 4 plus 1, 5. Okay, so here that means that 4 plus 0 plus 1. Okay, when write is given with 0. Okay, 0 means that no access. Okay, so there is no write permission. So here 4 plus 0 plus 1 means that it is 5. Okay, so that means that the others are given also with the read and execute permission. Okay, for the particular 5 called as the 5. Okay, so that is the absolute mode where you will be using numbers. Okay, so here whoever the categories of users you are having, those categories of users are specified with the numbers for the access permission. Okay, so here it is in order. Whatever the category of users we are having, it has to go in order. The order is like, first you have to specify the user, second group and third is the others. Okay, so where the first number user, if it is like 7, okay, 7 means that already you have said read is given 4, write is given 2 and execute is given with 1 value. Okay, so when we say 7, 7 means that 4 plus 2 plus 1. That means that read, write, execute permission are given for the users. Okay. And similarly 5. 5 means 4 plus 1. Okay. 4 plus 1. 4 plus 1 means that, okay, read and execute permission are given for the others. And similarly for the others also. Others also we are having the number as 5. 5 means that 4 plus 1, that means that others are also given with the read and execute permissions. Okay, so in this way, this is the absolute form for changing the permissions. So let's see some examples here. So here for my file, okay, for file my file. So here I am creating a file called as the my file. Okay, so here to grant read, write, and execute permissions. Okay, to grant read and write permissions to yourself, in the sense owner. Okay, so since I am the owner, so I am giving like read, write, execute permissions. Okay, so that is if I want to give read, write, execute. Okay, already I have said read is given with 2, read is given with 4, okay, write is given with 1 and execute equal to 1. Okay, if I want to give the owner with the read, write and execute permission, I have to say 4 plus 2 plus 1. Okay, so and similarly if it is like group, okay, so here read and execute permission, if I want to give the group, okay, group with read and execute permission, then I am simply saying 4 for read, so 0 for write, 1 for execute, I am getting 5. Okay, and only execute permission, for others. Okay, only execute permission in the sense 0 plus 0 plus 1. Okay, so that is 1. Okay, so here how it is given here, so here the command will be chmod. Okay, so here 7 in the sense first, already we have said it has to be given in order. First you have to say user, second group, and third is others. Okay, so the first number is 7, where you will be giving read, write, execute permission for my file. Okay, for the owners. And similarly second one is group, where you have given only read and execute permission, that is 4 plus 1 5 for the group. And third others are given only with the execute permission, that is 1 for the file my file. Okay, so and this is the example for this. First I have created the file. Okay, so first I have created the file called as my file with the command called as the touch command. Okay, by using the touch command I have created the file my file. After creating the file I have used the ls command for viewing the permissions of that file. Okay, so here when I am saying ls space minus l my file, okay, so by default the system has given these permissions to that particular file. Okay, now I want to change the permissions to that file. Since I want to change the permissions of that file, so here what I am saying is that, so chmod 751 my file. Okay, so that means that the users are given with read, write, execute permission, and the group is given with the read and execute permission, and others are given with the only execute permission. Okay, so that is nothing but 751. Okay, so for the file call as the my file. Okay, when I executed this, when I am saying ls space minus l my file, now you can view that. See all the permissions are given for the owners, read, write, execute, that is 7. Okay, and similarly the group are given with the read and execute permission, and for others are given only the execute permission. Okay, so that is okay. So similarly these are the other examples that there are. So here we are giving like 6. Okay, 6 in the sense that read and write. So this means that only read and write permission. Okay, since 6 means that, okay, 6 means that read and write, where read is given with 4 and write is 2, that means that 4 plus 2 equal to 6. Okay, so and similarly 4. Okay, so 4 means that, 4 means only read permission, since read is given only 4. And similarly for others also, others are also given with only the read permission. Okay, so here the groups are also given with the read permission, and here the owners are given with the read write permission. Okay, and this is another example where here also 7 means that read write execute permission, 4 plus 2 plus 1. Okay, so read write execute permission for the owners. Okay, and similarly for the group are given with the read and execute permission, that is 4+1. Okay, 4+1, that is read and execute permission, and similarly others are also given with the read and execute permission. Okay, so that is one example. Okay, and similarly this is also same example. 666 means that all the category of users are given with the read and write permission. Okay, so read and write permission, read write permission, that is 4 and 2, that is 4+2 equal to 6. Okay, so all the users read write permission, similarly group is also given with the read write permission, and others are also given with the read write permission. Okay, so and this one is chmod minus r. Okay, so minus r means recursive. Okay, so like this is my files, this is a directory here. Okay, this my file is a directory. Okay, this my file is a directory. Okay, when I'm saying minus r and these permissions to the users, okay, when I'm saying these permissions to the users and I'm saying in recursive mode means that all these permissions are applied to all the files and directories that are present in that directory. Okay, so here my files is a directory and this directory consists of some subdirectories and some files. Okay, so whatever the directories and files that are present in this my file directory, so for those files and directories also all these permissions are applied. Okay, so that is a recursive mode. So recursively minus r change the permissions of the directory my files. Okay, it not only changes the permissions of the directory my files, but also all the folders and files it contains. Okay, whatever the folders in the sense directory, whatever the directories and files it contains. Okay, whatever the folders and files it contains, those folders and files are also given the permissions of 755. Okay, so here not only my files, so here not only the directory my files, but all the folders and files that are contained in this directory my files, they are also given with the permissions of 755. Okay, which means that user can read, write and execute, and group members and others users can read and execute but cannot write. Okay, so here 7 means that the owners are given with read, write, execute, and the group and others, whatever the group and others, they are given only with the permission of read and execute. Okay, so that is the recursive mode where you can apply the permissions to the recursively to all the files and directories that are present in that directory. Okay, so that is about the chmod. Okay, so that is about the chmod where the chmod is used for, okay, for changing the permissions of a particular file. Where you have seen two methods, symbolic mode and absolute form. Okay, where in the symbolic form we will be using the symbols, or we can say that attributes like R, W, X, U, G, O, and some operators like plus, minus, equal to, for changing the permissions. Okay, and similarly you have seen the other method of the chmod, that is your absolute form, where in the absolute form you will be using the numbers. Okay, so numbers like it is given with a value of 4, right is given with a value of 2, and others are given with a value of 1. Okay, and you can specify by adding those values. Okay, by adding those values you can give permissions to the users, group and others. Okay, so those are the two forms of the chmod operation. Okay. So here the next method which we are having, or we can say another command that is available for changing the permissions of the file, is the chown command. Okay, chown command means change ownership. Okay, so here this command is used only to change the ownership of the file. Means that you can change only the users of the file. Okay, so here chown command is used to change the file owner or group. Okay, by using this command you can change the ownership of the file or you can change the group owner of the file. Okay, so whenever you want to change ownership, okay, if you want to change the ownership of the file, you can use the chown command. Okay, so the syntax, this is the syntax of your command. Okay, so this is the syntax of the command where chown option, okay, chown command option you have to say. If it is recursive, you can say minus R. Okay, so this is the option and then here you have to specify the owner, new owner. Okay, so here you have to specify the new owner to whom you want to change the ownership. Okay, and similarly group, so a new group name to whom you want to change the group ownership and then followed by the file name. Okay, so syntax chown, so if you want to, you can use some options and then you have to specify the owner name to whom you want to change the ownership and the group name to whom you want to change the group owner and then followed by the file name. Okay, so this is the example. See here, since chown master file1.txt. Okay, so this is the command and I want to change the ownership to this new owner master. Okay, he is going to be the new owner of the file. Okay, so here but suppose I am the owner of the file, I want to change the ownership of the file to some other user called as the master. Okay, so chown command to change the ownership. For suppose I am the owner of this file1.txt. Okay, I want to change the ownership of this file to another user called as the master. So what I have to do, I have to simply say chown and then the new ownership that I have to give is the master. So I am saying master and the file name. Okay, when you say this, that ownership, okay, the ownership of the file will be going to the user called as the master. Okay, so ls space minus l file1.txt. Okay, so when I am saying here, so if you see this output of this command, here the owner is the root. Okay, so here previously for this file1.txt, the owner is the root. Okay, so now that ownership has to be changed to the, okay, to the other user called as the master. Okay, so what that person is doing, chown, what that root is doing is that chown new owner name, okay, and then file1.txt. Okay, so when you say this command, the ownership will be going to the user called as the master. Okay, when we are saying ls space minus l file1.txt, now we can see that the ownership has been changed to the master. Okay, so this is the ownership, this ownership has been changed to the master. Okay, so the ownership is changed but the root is same, but the group is same. Okay, so we can see that the ownership has been changed. Okay, ownership has been changed from root to master. Okay, now the new owner of the file is the master. Okay, and we can see that the group has not been changed. Okay, so whatever the group, that is root, so the same group is still existing for that file. Okay, so that is how we can change the ownership of a particular file. Okay, so here there is an option called as the minus C. Okay, so minus C reports when a file change is made. Okay, that means that when the ownership change is made, so it gives like a message. Okay, it displays the message. Okay, so here so chown minus c master file1.txt. Okay, so where here the ownership is changed to the new user master. Okay, so here the ownership has been changed to the user called as the master. Okay, so if you see this, after saying enter, after giving this command, and when I am saying enter, Okay, after this, after giving this command, and when I say enter, so it is displaying a message. Okay, it is displaying a message called as changed ownership of file1.txt from root to master. Okay, so the ownership has been changed. Okay, when you are using the minus C option, so the ownership the ownership has been changed from the root to master, and whatever the change that has been made, so that message has been displayed. Okay, so and here when I am saying ls space minus l, okay, when I am saying my ls space minus l, so you can see that change. Okay, so here the ownership has been changed to master. Okay, so this minus C command is used for displaying the message. Okay, so if you see in the previous example, when without minus C option, okay, so if, when you are simply saying chown master file1.txt, so when you are saying here, when you are saying enter here, it is not displaying any message. Okay, so here the shell is not displaying any message about the change in ownership. Okay, but when you use the minus C, okay, when you use the minus C option here, when you say enter, after giving the command, when you say enter, so it is displaying the change in ownership. Okay, so here the shell is displaying a message that the changed ownership of file1.txt is from root to master. Okay, so that minus C reports, it displays the message, okay, of the change of the ownership. And similarly, if you want to change the ownership of the group, okay, so to change group ownership, so you have to simply say chown and you have to give this colon, okay, and new group, okay, so to whom you want to change the group owner, that new group owner and file1.txt. Okay, so this is the syntax for changing the group owner. If you want to change the group owner, you have to say chown and colon and then the new group owner and the file name. Okay, so if you see here, first I am displaying the permissions of that file1.txt by using the ls space minus l command. So here we can see that the owner, okay, so the owner of, the group owner of the file1.txt. Okay, so here we can see that the group owner of the file1.txt is the root. Okay, so here when we are saying chown colon group 1 file1.txt. Okay, so when we are saying colon here, the group owner has been changed from root to group 1. Okay, so here minus V is also used for displaying the message. Okay, when you give this command and when you say enter, so it is displaying the message that the changed ownership of file1.txt from master to root to group. Okay, so then here the owner, so previously here we can say that the group owner is root, now that group owner he has been changed to group. Okay, so that is the change ownership to changing the group owner. Okay, and similarly this is the next one where we can change for the owner and the group also. Okay, so here when I am saying like chown, so this will be like new owner, okay, new owner to whom I want to change the ownership, and new group owner to whom I want to change the group. Okay, so here I am saying chown minus v master group 1 greek 1. Okay, so here the previously the owner is root, okay, and even the group owner is also root. Okay, now I am changing the ownership from root to master, and similarly the group owner from root to group 1. Okay, so when we are saying that change that has been done, that has been displayed as a message. Okay, changed ownership of greek 1. Okay, so greek 1, that is your file name, from root to root. Okay, from root to root and master to group 1. Okay, so that means that this root, okay, so the root ownership has been changed to master, and this root group ownership has been changed to the group 1. Okay, so this root ownership has been changed to master ownership, and this root group ownership has been changed to the group 1 ownership. Okay, so that is the chown command, where chown command is used to change the ownership of the file, and similarly it can also be used to change the group owner of the file. Thank you.